I Hate Bats by Admiral Biscuit. There are many places in Equestria where one can appear, although most interdimensional travellers wind up in or near Ponyville. That's probably just as well. Not many would want to visit Griffinstorm. And to be honest, the Griffins are also quite relieved by this. He did not arrive in Ponyville. In fact, despite his vast knowledge of Equestria, he did not arrive anywhere he knew. To be fair though, his point of arrival was pitch black. Presently, our perfect protagonist deduced that he was in a cave because it smelled and sounded like an empty basement, only considerably bigger. Those were not the only smells or sounds. There was a horsey smell, which is not really a surprise for Equestria, along with a kind of fruity smell he couldn't identify straight away, and there was a continual soft screeing from above his head, and at that moment he realized that the fruity smell was mangoes. And it was mangoes because bat ponies love mangoes. And he was in a goddamn cave full of goddamn bat ponies. He proceeded to then scream. It is important to note that this was not a scream of terror. While there are undoubtedly some things that he is afraid of, bat ponies are not on that list. No, it was a scream of dismay, because he hated bat ponies. He didn't like their cute little fangs. He despised their leathery bat-like wings. The screeing noise that they made to communicate with each other and to echolate annoyed him. Biting fruit and drinking the juices was overly cannibalistic in his eyes. He thought ear nibbles were a threat, nor was he a fan of adorable tufted ears. Oddly, he didn't have anything bad to say about their cat-like eyes. This primal scream of dismay woke the bat ponies up, and they immediately dropped from their perches, calling out in confusion, filling the cave with a cacophony of noise. Imagine for a moment that you were peacefully sleeping in your bed, and you were suddenly awoken by a horse, screaming, in dismay, not terror. Wouldn't you be a little bit confused too? It did not take them too long to identify the source of the noise, the stranger in their midst, and they quickly circled down to study him. While this, of course, is perfectly normal bat pony behaviour, to him it was understandably alarming. He couldn't make out any shapes in the darkness, but he could hear the whooshing of air over their wings, and he could feel the air currents as they zipped close enough to touch, and had he dared to reach an arm out. He was a conundrum, an enigma, and they chittered and screed to each other, discussing this interloper in their cavern. He was no predator who had sneaked in. Of that they were sure. Anything further, they had no idea. They could have easily enough simply returned to their perches and ignored him, unless he had some heretofore undiscovered ability to jump. He could not have grabbed a single sleeping bat pony even if he had tried. Even in the darkness, he would have found a way out of their sleeping chambers eventually. Despite his deep-seated dislike of them, they were gracious to a fault and decided to treat him as an honoured, if unexpected, guest. Several flew over to their mango piles and selected the largest, ripest, and sweetest fruits, and they grasped them reverently in their hooves and flew over to him, setting them gently at his feet. Others, observing his clothing, came to the entirely logical conclusion that he might be cold, and despite his protest, proceeded to cluster around him, gently nuzzling him, and also nibbling at his ears, because that's how they show affection. Bat pony caves generally have two features, darkness and isolation. The first is rather obvious. Caves are dark in general, and a nocturnal creature will of course prefer to sleep in a dark cave rather than a well-lit one. The second is perhaps less obvious, but given that bat ponies can fly, and that they can sleep during the day, having a cave that isn't frequently explored by day dwellers is a huge advantage. Being well suited to darkness, they of course have no need for artificial light, and as such escorting him out of the cave was quite the challenge. Bat ponies aren't dumb, and of course it didn't take them too long to figure out that in their cave he was, well, blind as a bat. Nevertheless, they persisted, and once he deigned to rest his hand on the guide's back, they got him out of the blessed darkness of the cave and into the dusklight that filtered through the mouth of the cave. His eyes were by then well adjusted to the dark, and so from there it was a little trouble to make his way to the mouth of the cave and... Remember how bat ponies can fly? Well, there are probably no unclimbable mountains to an experienced mountaineer with the right equipment, but he was not, and had not, and thus found himself stranded at a small opening in a large cliff, with nothing but the clothes on his back and a pocket full of fruit. A moment before, perhaps his opinions of bat ponies would have been swayed, the memory of his hand upon her back as she escorted him through the twisting tunnels of their warren, or the enticing smell of mangoes, or the velvety feel of a muzzle nuzzling him could have drowned out the hatred in his heart. But alas, here he was, peering out over a yawning chasm, with no way down. "I hate bats," he muttered.